Now, unless you've been living under a rock, I'm just gonna go out and assume that everybody's seen Fate Zero by now. But let's pretend that you haven't. Let's pretend that you watch Fate the right way. And that means seeing Stay Night first. In that case, you have no idea why Kirei was able to survive against Hassan. And that is what we're here for today. We're gonna talk about why Kirei was able to survive against Hassan's phantasm and how this man is literally too insane to die. So at the end of Fate Zero, Kirei faced off against Shiro's father, Kiritsugu, in a battle to the death during the Grail War. Kirei lost this fight, however, which ultimately resulted in him getting his heart blown out of his chest. This means that Kirei had already lost his life in the previous Grail War. So why is he still alive? Well, since the Greater Grail was malfunctioning after Kiritsugu finished him off, his body ended up being revived via the contract that he had with Gil. Going through this process, Kirei was reborn with an artificial black heart courtesy of Angrimanyu. This means that despite dying the first time, he could continue to live on as long as he had a connection to Angra. The problem with Kirei's heart being artificial is that for Hassan to use his phantasm, it assumes that you must be operating on the ordinary functioning heart. This artificial heart made Kirei register as a dead man. Thus, Hassan's attack could only give non-effective results. Joke's on you, homeboy. You can't kill me if I'm already dead. As far as Kirei's exorcism goes, the location for that event was moved around for the sake of convenience. Originally, the event took place in the Einsburn Forest, where, in the midst of fighting Hassan, Kirei jumped 10 meters into the air, grabbed Zoken out of a tree, and slammed him directly into the ground. Just merciless. He then follows this up by respectfully smearing Zoken's brains all over the wall. Now, if you don't know about their vendetta, you might think this is a bit overboard, but in the past, Zoken has actually exposed Kirei for his inability to empathize with others, making their beef a lot more personal. During the Fourth Grail War, Zoken told Kirei to his face, "Let's not kid ourselves around here. You're really just as sick and twisted as I am." And at a time where Kirei was still trying to understand himself as a person, this remark infuriated him. He could only respond by putting a hole through Zoken's head. But then he finds out that Zoken's true body isn't actually there. Zoken further taunts this man by saying, "Oh, did I hit a nerve? Don't take it so personal. Just come back and see me when you get on my level." Oh, word? That's how we coming? Say no more. Now, the first time around, Kirei didn't know Zoken was using an avatar. But the second time, now that he has a better understanding to the situation, "We ain't got nothing to talk about. You getting straight executed." And he knew that the exorcism would be the best way of doing so. Anything else you'd like to get off your chest, old man? Wait, what's that? You say you don't have a chest? Oh, okay, didn't think so. Unfortunately for Kirei, this heart could only last him so long. Fast forward to the confrontation that he has with Sakura in Fate Stay Night, and we see things begin to change. With Sakura being the practical surrogate mother to Angra, she had direct access to the energy that was giving Kirei his second lifeline. While she's in this conversation with Kirei, Sakura mentions that she crushed this lifeline, meaning that every move that Kirei made from this point on was on borrowed time. The literal dead man walking. It also served to complement the fact that the protagonist was also breaking down due to Archer's arm. But yeah, this is the actual reason that Kirei was able to survive. I'm having a lot of fun making these, revisiting all these old scenes, and just reminding myself why the novel was so great once again. I did see a couple of comments on my third magic video that I already plan to address, so be on the lookout for those. Anyways, like the video if you enjoyed it. Follow me on Twitter for more updates on the channel. Shout out to the patrons, and I will be back with more Tight Moon content. It's your boy Tsiah. I'm out.